बदरी बदरिया गिरे गजरी
wonderful people. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Ambika's brother, Arun, and I have the slightly unusual pleasure of being today's maid of honor. For those of you who don't know already, Ambika is still very much a child at heart. Her favorite films are the Disney classics, and she loves Minions more than anything. Even you, Mittal. So I'm going to tell like a little bit of a story here. When I was very young, one thing Ambika would love to do, when I was very, very young, she'd like dress me up as a girl and parade me around, tell everyone she was Cinderella and I was her ugly sister. Indeed, even today, I rely upon her to tell me which clothes to wear and which to avoid. Almost every piece of clothing I've been wearing the last few days has been her choice as well. So I must say I am quite relieved that she didn't force me to take the role of maid of honor too literally. Her bubbly spirit has brought happiness to everyone around her, caring for us, each and every one of us, guiding us through the most difficult times and being a constant light in our family. I can't thank her enough for everything she's done for me. And I know with all my heart that these qualities will make her an exceptional life companion. Mittal, you are a lucky man. Together, they have already faced great challenges. For example, the emotional weight of a long-distance relationship. She's been working in London or Southampton and he's been in Nairobi or all over the world at some point. And I've seen how difficult it's been for Ambika to deal with Mittal's absence. And I know it must have been just as hard for him. With regards to Ambika, someone who's so naturally upbeat, it's a very sad thing to see. At the same time, however, we were also able to see their relation when they were together. And it's those happy moments that it's clear to all of us that they have the strength to sustain that joy the rest of their lives. If I had to describe Ambika's ideal husband when I was a child or even now if you asked me, I'd have to say, given Ambika's love of Disney, he'd have to be a real Prince Charming. And Mittal really showed up for that conversation when it came to proposing. Knowing exactly what would make Ambika happy, booked the prize trip for the two of them to Disney World, Florida, waited for the perfect moment, hired a horse and carriage, all works, took them to a beautiful vista, and watched on the Disney Tower when fireworks came, and he asked her to be his wife. So I have to admit, sets the bar pretty high, so yeah, thanks for that, Madonna. So on this evening of celebration, as our two families come together, I know just how much I'm going to miss the company, the consideration, and the laughter of my favorite sister. And yet I know the distance will not be an obstacle, and the happiness of a new life will be a source of joy to all of us in the years to come. The only Wadwa granddaughter lost her surname today, but this is not a day to be sad. I'm not losing a sister. I'm gaining a brother within a much larger, happy family, between which distance will only make the heart grow fonder. Ambika, I'm certain your Prince Charming Mittal will make all your dreams come true. So, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in raising your glasses to the bride and the groom. Meet the Vellanis.
Oh, cheers.
Cheers.
Now is the turn of the best man, Nishant, Nishant Vellani.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Nishant, the more handsome of the two Vellani brothers.
And modest, obviously.
First of all, I would like to thank all of you for coming here, being a part of the union that we've witnessed of Ambika and Mittal. I think we all agree that the past few days of celebration have been absolutely amazing. From the cocktail reception to the mandap and mandi, and then the sangeet and the wedding today morning. I want to tell you a few stories about Mittal. Not so embarrassing ones at all, we'll see. Me and him obviously go back a long way, and I want to take you back to Kenya where we grew up and tell you a bit of a story about some of the qualities of Mittal. The things he does, basically. He likes to sleep. I remember when we were young, 5, 6, 7 years old, we used to have an afternoon nap and then often have tea and biscuit as a snack. More often than not, Mittal would fall asleep at the table with a biscuit in his hand, his head down. And he still loves his morning lines. I just hope he's never fallen asleep at the table on the day of Mittal. The other thing with Mittal is that he loves his food. And when he's hungry, he can get a bit grumpy. So he always has to make sure he's well fed. I say these two things because I want to give you a quick crash course on how to look after him. Okay. Think of it as a handy guide for the new bride. It's a simple formula, really. It's sleep plus food equals a happy meal. Not much at all. Okay. I would like to compliment you, Amika, and everyone as maid of honor, who look absolutely wonderful today. Especially Amika, you look beautiful as a stunning bride. Mittal is a kind and loving person, gentle, caring, considerate, and in Ambika, he's found his other half, who is equally loving and caring. I'm also glad that in Ambika, he's found someone who loves watching Twilight and the Big Bang Theory as much as he does. And so, I want to officially welcome you to the Vellani family, and I would ask everyone to raise your glasses to the happy couple. May your future be blessed with love, joy, and happiness, and of course, many chubby babies.
to Mr. Lollapalooza.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege, and I would say scary honor, to say a few words to the newly bride and groom, newly married couple, and welcome you all, and thank you all. You have been a very wonderful audience, guests to this function. And a function is good only with people like you attending it. So thank you very much for being such good guests. On behalf of Aruna and myself, Mavi and Lakshmi, Amrita and Mithil, we are very appreciative of the effort and sacrifices you have done to be with us. You have spent time and resources to come to Udaipur, for which we are very grateful, and we are humbled by your desire to honor the commitment Ambika and Mithil have made to each other. So thank you very much.
Can I ask you to give yourself a big round of applause?
Now I have to say a few words to Ambika and Mithil. Ambika, as I look to you as a stunningly beautiful young woman, a new bride, in an incredibly gorgeous outfit, I can't help but look back on the last 28 years we have spent together, for most of which I was the man in your life. And tonight, you are moving to a new era, as you should. It is a good thing me and your mom prepared you for this, but I can't help look back at the time we spent together. The day you were born was the happiest and most memorable day of my life. For two reasons.
Witness.
Participating and helping your mom in your delivery, being our firstborn, it was a long and hard labor for your mom. And seeing a new life begin in front of my eyes was incredible. So all fathers, all young people who are going to be fathers in the next few years or whatever, please, don't miss that opportunity. We are lucky, I was very lucky, seeing Ambika born was absolutely memorable. And when Ambika was born, me and Aruna was of course all over the moon. And that was the second reason why it became the most happiest and memorable for all of us. I can remember the moment you were first introduced to me. You were wrapped in a tightly hospital blanket. Part of your face was covered with a hospital towel. Your wrinkly face, I couldn't take my eyes off. I went through in my mind all the dreams of adventure we will have together. And sure enough, the last 28 years, I lived the most of them. Our visit to Disney World, Florida, when you were one, walking you to your first day to school, taking you to swimming and dancing lessons, your craze with the Spice Girls, the incredible chemistry you had with my father, your India daddy. The memorable holidays all over the world we had with you. You have always been the Vadhava family's travel or tour operator, travel agent. She looks for all the nice places for us to go. I hope you will carry on doing that. Trials and tribulations of your school exams, your graduations, our connections with Bollywood, movies and the music. When I was young, I used to think I can say, I can listen to a tune and see and tell you where it's wrong. I'm a complete idiot. Our watching EastEnders with religious regularity. We are very happy predicting what the script is going to be in the next few episodes. Our search for your first pharmacy. Your excitement at becoming a businesswoman. The list goes on. All of these have been very memorable events in my life. I can honestly say, I saw life more fully through your eyes. Your energy, your enthusiasm, your bubbly spirit, the way you pour into people and attract all the good things in life. I lived and loved life more deeply because of what you brought to my life. And I'm so grateful that God gave me that Ambika time and I was able to share that with you and be a better person as a result of that. I'm grateful to be your papa and I'm proud of the woman you have become. And today, I feel a special kind of pride as I hand you to the new man in your life. And you start a new adventure together. Now, Mithal. 6 months before I met Amika, Aruna and I started praying for you. One of the first things we thought and that filled our minds when we were first pregnant, expecting that when this child was developing and growing, we need to start praying for the person God is going to create and develop and grow into that person forever. As a side note, I'm pretty sure if my maths is right, just around the time you were born. We didn't know who you are, where you live, what you look like. We would not have recognized you even if we had met you in your primary school. But we knew God was designing you as the perfect match for Africa. As I have known you over the last few years, I have begun to realize that both of you have such complementary skills and attributes that I'm sure the sum total of your union is many times more than the sum total of your individual skills and attributes. So friends, raise your glasses with me if you would. Ambika and Mithal have tonight joined hands and hearts. We, as your family and friends, look back and recognize the moments that have brought them to this point. We relish the sparkle in their eyes as we saw as children, and tonight we see something just a little different. We see a new love, a new beginning, which has given birth to a brand new joy. May God bless you and His grace shine upon you all.
Thank God.
Being here tonight and over the past 3 days. You have come from all over, India itself, Kenya, UK, Australia, Canada, Singapore, Thailand, USA, Dubai, and words cannot express how much it means to us that you're all here with us as we begin this journey together in the next chapter of our lives. I would like to thank Vamak and I for our papa and mama as well for the wedding of our dreams. I know it's been a long road, planning and a lot to do, and it has been absolutely wonderful. I'd also like to thank you for welcoming me into your family with open arms. Accept me for who I am, how I am, what I am, and who I can do you proud. You have been absolutely instrumental in raising such a wonderful person, and I cannot be more proud of calling her my wife from this day onwards. I'd also like to thank my papa and mommy for making me who I am today. Without their love, support, inspiration, I wouldn't be here. You have guided me, you have supported me in doing in everything I wanted to do in life, and I thank you for that. I also thank you for organizing a lot of things. As the best man said, if things were left to me, I would be sleeping, and would have woken up and walked to the mandap instead of having a comfortable ride on an elephant. So thank you for everything. I'd also like to thank my sister Rui, without whom a lot of things would not have been possible. She has dealt with my stubbornness, my anger when I'm hungry, when I'm sleepy, and made sure that everything's been planned to the team. With the perfect Excel sheets, which I couldn't figure out at all. Thank you very much for being there. I can't forget the rest of my family, Claire and Akshay, for always keeping up the motto of keep calm and get married. So, thank you for always keeping me calm, along with my favorite chubbers, Rihan and Niven, where as soon as I would see their faces, all the stress, everything would just go away. Thank you very much. Now for the best man. I don't know what to say about him. He's said a lot about me, so.
throughout the whole wedding time, he's only been interested in whether he has an elephant to come along with me. I say there's no space, because this is my time now, you had yours. So, along with what he would wear, what the menu has, what type of turban he's going to have, I had to make sure of one thing, that I give him the toughest jobs of all. To get me ready in the mornings, which was hard, to make sure my bow tie is tied, which my age is on. But he was there throughout the journey. You have been there to guide me through the tough times and the happy times, and I'll always look up to you as my big brother. I'd like to thank Annika's for the lovely speech, and who is being by her side. It means a lot to me as well. I'd like to thank the beautiful bridesmaids for always being there with her, supporting her, having been there for her to talk to as well. Thank you very much. And last but not least, Ambika. I cannot be more proud of calling you. You look absolutely stunning tonight. You have been looking absolutely stunning every day. And I count myself lucky to have met you. I must have done something right in my life to have found places like you. As Arun said, one of the most important days of my life came when I asked her to marry me. And she said yes. I was speechless. Who knew a guy like me, not that bad, who knew a person like me would find such a beautiful, loving, gentle, and kind person to spend the rest of my life with? Thank you. It makes me feel like I'm not that bad. In you, I found my home. My friend, my love, you make me laugh, you hold me when I need to cry. You have made me whole, and I feel alive when I'm with you. I will love and respect you as an individual, a partner, and an equal. I will honor, encourage, and support you. I am yours, and I'm overjoyed to say that you are mine. I love you. Once again, can we leave these old rays and glasses? To everyone here, to all the family and friends, to my new mama papa, to my mommy papa, and my bride, cheers.
Cheers.
जाओ जी मन बीत कराओ जी रा क्यों तरसावे हो मन सकल दिखाओ जी थारी शरारत सब जानू मैं तो धरी अरसले उन बंगा दी मैं कह लगे मर बुड़े में जागी दो कणी चंदा में थारी चांदनी मन दामन में पा भी खुशी रे झुम 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 बा झुम ओ मर इबड़े में जागी धोकनी रे चंदा में थारी चांदनी मन दामन में पा भी खुशी रे झुम 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 बा झुम
married couples, come on the floor, guys. This song is dedicated to you.
White, you gotta get a white.